Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss the measurement of power and energy chapter, and the topic is measurement of DC power. Okay, so let us put the heading measurement of DC power. Okay, so in the measurement of DC power, we are having the two methods. One is the voltmeter ammeter method, and second one is ammeter voltmeter method. Okay, one is the voltmeter ammeter, and second one is ammeter voltmeter. Okay, so let us first discuss the voltmeter ammeter method. Okay. For that, the circuitry right load is purely resistive, because in the DC circuit we are having only resistive load. Voltage across load VL, current flowing through load IL. Okay, this is the ammeter, this is the voltmeter. Okay, let us consider the ammeter resistance is RA. Okay, resistance of the ammeter is RA. Okay, now why it is known as the voltmeter ammeter method? Because in this method, first of all, voltmeter is connected, and after that, the ammeter is connected. Means the ammeter is connected at the load side, whereas the voltmeter is connected at the supply side. Okay, and here we will be having the DC supply. Okay, so how we find or how we calculate the power consumed by the load, right? It is equal to reading of the ammeter and the reading of the voltmeter. Okay, so we can write measured power. I am writing here measured power is equal to voltmeter reading into ammeter reading. Voltmeter reading into ammeter reading. Right. Next, if you check the voltmeter reading, is nothing but voltage across load plus voltage across ammeter. Okay, because the potential difference between these two points is nothing but potential difference between or across the ammeter and the potential difference across the load. Okay, so can we write voltmeter reading is nothing but VA plus VL. Okay, into ammeter reading is, it is a same as ammeter is connected in series with the load, so ammeter the reading is nothing but the current flowing through the ammeter, which is equal to IL only. Okay, so if you check, it is equal to VA into IL plus VL into IL. Okay, so VA into IL is nothing but voltage across ammeter, current flowing through the ammeter. Okay, and this is VL into IL is nothing but voltage across the load into current flowing through the load. So can we say that it is equal to power consumed by ammeter? I am writing it as P ammeter is power consumed by ammeter. Okay, and plus power consumed by the load, that is a PL. Okay, so we can write it as measured power, that is PM, is equal to P ammeter plus P load. Okay, and P load is nothing but your, it is like a true power. Okay, it is like a true power. Okay, next I am writing PM is greater than PT, that is nothing but a true power, where PT is equal to PL, that is true power is equal to load power. Okay, means the measured power is greater than that of the true power, means this method consists of the error, and the error is nothing but power consumed by the ammeter. And if you check, the ammeter is connected at the load side. Okay, so can we say that here the error is due to the power consumed by the load side element or the load side device. Okay, The second one we are going to discuss is the ammeter voltmeter method. Right? Ammeter voltmeter method, AV method. Okay, ammeter voltmeter method. So in this method, so first of all, ammeter is connected, and after that, the voltmeter is connected. So ammeter is connected at the supply side, voltmeter is connected at the load side. Here it is the ammeter. Next, load. Here we have the voltmeter. Right? This is the RL, IL, VL. Right? Suppose this is IV. Current flow through the voltmeter, that is IV, okay, and current flow through the ammeter is IE. Okay, now this is the DC supply, yes. So in this case, the measured power is equal to same ammeter reading into voltmeter reading. Ammeter reading into voltmeter reading. Right? What is the ammeter reading? It is IA. What is the voltmeter reading? It is like voltmeter is connected across the load. So voltmeter voltage across the load is same as that of the voltmeter reading. Okay. IA into VL. Again, can we say that IA is equal to this IA? If you apply KCL here, IA is equal to IV plus IL, right? So IA can be replaced with IV plus IL into VL. Okay, so we can write it as is equal to IV into VL plus IL into VL. Okay, now if you check here, this is equal to IV into VL is nothing but voltage across load, that is nothing but which is same as that of the voltage across load is same as that of the voltage across the voltmeter, okay, into IV means current flowing through the voltmeter. So can we say that this IV into VL, it indicates the power consumed by the voltmeter, right? Power consumed by voltmeter, right? Plus what is VL into IL? It is a load power. It is a true power. So we can write as power measured, that is a PM, is equal to measured power, that is a PM, is equal to power consumed by the voltmeter, that is PV, plus load power, that is a PL. Okay. So here PM is greater than PT. PT is true power, okay, where PT, that is true power, is nothing but power consumed by the load. Okay, so here measured power is greater than true power, means this reading or this type, this method also consists of the error. Okay, and the error is due to the power consumed by the voltmeter. And if you check, the voltmeter is connected at the load side. Okay, so in both the methods the errors are due to power consumed by the device or the meter which is connected at the load side. Okay, this is the very very important conclusion. Okay, so this is about the measurement of DC power by ammeter voltmeter and voltmeter ammeter method. Okay, try to understand in both the methods the error is due to the power consumed by the device or the meter which is connected at the load side. Okay, and what is the power? How we calculate the power? The power is nothing but the product of voltmeter reading and ammeter reading. Okay, in one of the method, VA method, voltmeter is connected at the supply side, ammeter is connected at the load side. Whereas in the AV method, ammeter is connected at the supply side, voltmeter is connected at the load side. Thank you.